That's okay, right? If you don't recognize it, you ask and they tell you. So you could hitchhike at one point. And now, several exposés on Fox 25 News and 10 later, you would be crazy to hitchhike. We just don't do it anymore. It's dangerous. It's wrong. It's not safe to pick somebody up. It's not safe to be the person picked up. There was a couple key moments that could take a broad-based, highly useful social phenomenon and tip it into a zone where it doesn't happen. It happens very rarely. It happens in a very specific circumstance. And my claim is that the social basis underlying the technology that came out of left field and then up in the mainstream and came back, the much better planned and content-oriented technologies like the information appliances that the PC beat out and the proprietary networks like CompuServe, the internet beat out, that they are vulnerable to this kind of tipping point. This is a hard argument to make. I respect that. And people are like, look, things are still going great, but I do my best in the book to explain why I see great reasons that the barge might be turning. These are just some of the comments pending on my blog at the Oxford Internet Institute. It's not about pharmaceuticals, my blog. And yes, you would think it might be in the comments because robots come along to work that install and just leave one on that comment after that, pointing back to their own standing website. And so the news ends up approved. My blog, being followed by the Google robot, will show all these pointers to the Google robot and indexing its own site to Google search. Will think, wow, that's a really popular site. When somebody asks for internet, maybe what they really want can't be. So we fight back against that, and yet the fight is being lost. It is being lost right now using traditional methods of outsourcing and capture things like that. We see this at the PC level, where the PCs we own designed with this open faith that if you allow anybody to easily ask, or sometimes not even ask, to run code on your machine, the code will basically be there for good purposes. And yet, we see a huge rise in the number of instances out there, tons of machines, very powerful, almost at 20% of the math, that are running code for terrible purposes, usually unbeknownst to the person who has the machine. You look inside what's going on in your Mac or PC, name it, standard generative desktop box. Nobody has any idea what any of this stuff does. None. We know what the labels are, but who even knows if the thing under the label is what it purports to be? I don't know what Pico does. I don't know if it's on my Mac. I don't remember it's